No one is allowed to highlight and give more importance to any parts of the Torah more than other parts of the Torah. You cannot say this verse is more important than that verse, or this chapter is more important than other chapter, or this chapter is more interesting than other, or this chapter is more substantial than other. This chapter of the Torah is more powerful than other. All of those words is not allowed. You can't even mention such thing. Why? Every letter of the Torah is equally important and equally substantial. Sometimes we don't understand the depth of the verse. Sometimes we don't understand. Okay, you don't understand. But you cannot say, oh, this part is more important. No. Every word of God is equally important. That's why the Sfaradim, when you read the Ten Commandments on Shabbat 2 times a year, they don't stand. Ashkenazim, they stand. They say, well, the Ten Commandments were given on a separate board. It has some more substantial. You know, it's more important. Therefore, God gave it on a separate piece of board, you know, the tablets. So they stand. Sfaradim say it's questionable. Why? Yes, it was given on a board. It's true. But it's written in the Torah also. If you stand in one part of the Torah and you sit in the other, that shows that some parts of the Torah are more important than others. That's not a good education to the children. Because later on, chas v'shalom, they're going to start going to the direction of the reform wicked people that started to pick and choose. Today they don't keep one word of the Torah. It's nothing to talk about. They do everything the opposite of the Torah. But in the beginning, 200 years ago, when that lousy movement started, they only made minor changes in the beginning. But that's how it is. When you begin to lose hair, it's no big deal in the first day. 50 hairs are in the sink. Still have 50,000 other hairs on your head. What's 50 for you compared to 50,000? Tomorrow, another 50. Next day, another 50. 3 years later, your head is shinier than a mirror. What happened? It's a process. The reform movements did not become so wicked overnight. It's more than 220 years. Today they marry men with men. Today they marry Jews with goyim. They mechalel Shabbat. They eat pork on Yom Kippur. Play piano in a shul, putting cross and Magen David next to each other. Disaster. If you have a pouring rain now, massive rain, in the middle of nowhere, you're in some city somewhere, you see a mosque in one side and a reformed temple on the other side. You want to pray, but you cannot pray because it's pouring rain. It takes away your concentration. You want to hide from the rain. So you have a choice to enter the mosque to pray with the murderers, the terrorists over there, the Muslim terrorist who wants to slaughter every Jew and every Christian and every other human being, or to go to the reform doctors, lawyers, judges, fashion show designers, politicians, bankers, chairmen of the board. Who are those reform people? Brain surgeon, cardiologist. They're all over there. They came with their cigar and Bentley once a year on Yom Kippur into that temple. So you want to enter the building, which is empty all year round. They come once or twice a year. Put $50 million in a building, maybe once or twice they show up. After Corona, they don't show up at all. It's all by the Zoom. They have a Zoom prayer. I don't know who they're praying to, but that's another question. But that's what it is. Now you want to hide. You see an empty place. Wow, they built it very nice. Big, fancy, kinds of pictures. They even have a kosher Torah in the ark. They buy a Torah they have plenty of money. They buy original Torah, $50,000-$60,000 they buy. And you have the Hamas terrorists, Hezbollah, all the Nazis. Where are you allowed to hide from the rain? You're allowed to enter the mosque and you're not allowed to step one step into the Reform synagogue. You can't step there one step. There and in a church, you're not allowed to step in. In a mosque, even though it's a fake religion, Islam, but you're allowed to enter in. Why? They're not idol worshippers. They follow a fake religion, a fake prophet. So what do you see from here? That an idol worshipper is a bigger danger to be around him than to be around a murderer. A murderer wants to slaughter you. An idol worshipper, worship is his statue. The effect on a soul is more dangerous than the effect on a body. The Gemara says it in few places. Gadol ha-machtio yoter min ha-orgo. Impurity can be more deadly than physical threat. People don't get it. And that's the problem. That people only live like they are another species in nature. Animals afraid to die, so they run when there's danger. They don't have spirituality, the animals. Most people in the world are like animals. 99.999% of the people in the world live like animals. No connection to God. And those Jews and Gentiles who believe in God, but don't know Torah, they never learn Torah. How do they connect to the God? They have no way to connect with Him. They don't know what's allowed, what's not allowed, how to talk to Him, how to pray, what's allowed to be told, what's not allowed. They don't know anything. How to dress when you pray, nothing. They don't know. No idea.